Of course, that came to home. She was quite the fire goddess in elementary school. And I remember the moment that we both found out we were at a sleepover. I was at his place with a thin window curtain and a duffel bag with a pillow, covered in Cheeto crumbs. And I start talking, gossiping with him. I'm like, hey man, guess who I like? He's like, oh, tell me. Have you got any quiet ideas? He's like, sits up in his bed. And when he had bug eyes too, okay. It was pitch black, like black, okay, but I could see them. They were so wide, I could see his eyes. It was the most terrifying thing. And he kind of just says, "Do you know? I like Christina Myers. She's mine." That was the moment we became arch nemesis. From that moment on. A couple days later, we were in the cafeteria. I'm eating chicken tenders with Christina Myers. The best dang chicken tenders, okay? We're dipping in the honey mustard together as a unit. Next thing I know, Stephen Henry comes walking up, fake trips, spills chocolate milk all over my white polo. It looked like I was up against a wall and I had explosive diarrhea. And it shot back up against the wall and hit me in the shirt. It sucked. She no longer had eyes for me. So I plotted. This consumed me. Consumed me. I went into the dark recesses of my room. Turned on my computer lamp. I started drawing schematics. I started planning, plotting. I was like, I'm gonna get him back. This guy's going down. He just doesn't know it yet, but I'm getting my revenge. And it's the last thing on this earth that I do. What I came up with was the most evil, diabolical thing on the planet. I was gonna take a thermos of Kool-Aid and dump it on him. For elementary school kid, you know, that's pretty intense, you know? It's just, come on, a whole thermos? This was like the camping one, like, pfft. I was gonna get him. Now I had my plan. I just had to find the time. That's it. He was going down. A field trip at the zoo. This was my time. Why the zoo? I don't know. It just felt right. Some things just felt right in the universe. It was just the time, you know? Next thing I know, I'm on the bus. Christina Myers is across from me. Stephen Fartface Henry is behind me. And we're going to the zoo, okay? We get to the zoo. It is a scorcher. 110, okay? Hot. Super hot. Muy caliente. I start going, looking at the animals, giraffes, gorillas, and a crane. They had one crane. The whole day, all I brought, because I was so consumed with this plane, was a thermos of Kool-Aid. That's the liquid I brought. And it wasn't cold, okay? The thermos was just heating in the sun. So by the time that I need something. I'm British. I started drinking out of the thermos. Okay, the Kool-Aid. That is ingenious. Okay? And my mom put like way too much sugar in this thing. Like 4 to 5 to 6, maybe 10 scoops of sugar in a pitcher. I don't know why she did that. That was just my mom. Maybe she thought I was a sweetie. I don't know. But I start drinking this all through the exhibits, drinking this Kool-Aid. It's awful. It's so bad, but this is all they had. So after the zoo trip, we get back on the bus. We're on the bus, and I sit down. Christina Myers is next to me. Stephen, friggin' fart. you know, Henry behind me again. And the teacher gets up, and the little zoo counselor's up there. It's like, come here. She pops off, goes and talks to her. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is it. It's time. I sit up, standing up in the bus. Like, everybody's sitting down. I turn, kneel down, right, on the seat, and I'm looking straight at him. And he just goes, and I wanted to say, not today, not today! But about that time, a projectile stream of red Kool-Aid vomit shoots out of my mouth into Stephen Henry's friggin' face, right? Everybody starts screaming, right? The bus driver's like, oh no! The only person that really saw it that could have given me away, and that there was this gardener cutting the tree, and he just had a perfect view into the bus, right? And he just is seeing this, and he goes, "Help me, Ablo! Help me, Ablo!" Guy literally thought I was possessed by the devil. I wouldn't blame him. It was a Mega Man blaster, freaking with a full oh yeah to the face. I got him. But Christina Meyer definitely didn't have eyes for me anymore. So yeah, time, man. That crap sucks. That was like bullet time. That was the worst. Well, guys, guess what? We got a great show for you tonight. We got Elliot Morgan. You guys like him? We got Mike Falzone. We got Tessa Violet. And we got Rusty Clampton and his band. You guys ready for this?
All right, guys. Here we go. Elliot Morgan, come on out. Come on, where is Elliot? There he is, there we go. There you go, buddy. How you guys doing? Well, you guys look like a hurricane happened and you came here for shelter. Makes sense, it's called the fortress, so that's good. This is my first time in Nashville. It's really great, I love it. I have a little bit of constructive criticism for you. I'm just gonna submit this to you. It's totally up to you. If you wanna take it or leave it. Maybe be less nice. It's freaking me out. I can't really handle it at all. I've been here for like 2 days, and I already feel like a golfer, ray of sunshine all the time. And that's not my style, you know? I'm like kind of a darker guy, you know? It's hard to slip into like an existential crisis when I'm sipping lemonade out of a mason jar and a striped straw. Here's the thing that they don't tell you about happiness. It's a gateway drug. Happiness is like the marijuana of emotions. Because you feel it, and you're like, oh, this is great. I'm happy. But I wonder what fulfillment would feel like, too. And then maybe you get fulfillment, and after that, you're like, oh, man. I wonder what it would be like to feel meaning. And then, like, maybe through like religion or whatever, you experience meaning, and then after that, you're like, I wonder what cocaine feels like. So it's like the same thing. You guys have a lot of really good food here. I gave up carbs this year because I got tired of enjoying eating. I was trying to lose a little bit of weight because I'm what's called skinny fat. That's my body type. Are there any skinny fat dudes in here? Yeah, by yourself, I bet. No. But like, because the thing is, like if you look at me, okay, I'm wearing clothes right now, and you're probably looking at me thinking like, that is okay at best. But here's the thing, if I were to like take my clothes off and like appear just like naked before you all today, I would be more accurately described as like a gay Grinch who just like, just like, hey, it's Christmas. Hey, you're my top, Max. So I'm trying to de-susify myself a little bit. Hey, I've been thinking about quitting the internet. What do you guys think about that? No? I feel like I've seen all of it.
Yeah!
You're like, please, stop everything we're doing, quit! It's too much. It's time to wrap it up. I think I've seen, I'm on all the social media sites, okay? To the point where I feel like I've just lost all sense of self. Like, when I look in a mirror now, I don't even see a reflection. I just see a crappy profile picture that hasn't been properly filtered or angled. I'll never double tap it. On Facebook, that's great. I was on Facebook recently, and this photo showed up in my feed, and it was what's called an image macro. It's like one of those photos with like text on it or whatever. Some people think they're not called image macros, some people think they're called themes, but some people thought Avatar had an original plot. You can't win all your battles. Which, by the way, really fast, let's stop right there. Let's pause on this Avatar bullcrap. I know it came out a while ago. You know in the movie, like, they're going for, like, unobtainium? That's what they called it. They're like, what's the thing? It was like, they might as well have called it James Cameron wanted to go home early that day, and they're like, well, James, what should we call the thing that, like, they want to get, but they can't get? And James Cameron was like, I don't know, it's unobtainable, it's an element, bye! And he, like, closed the hatch of a submarine and, like, descended into the abyss, as he do. It's a crappy movie. Anyway, so this photo shows up, and it's a photo of Beyonce, and she's like looking all fierce or whatever, and the text on it said, Beyonce only has 24 hours in the day, too. And I was like, oh my goodness. I had no idea. And this photo, like, kind of caught me in one of my more cynical moods, or as I like to call them, the daytime. So I got on there and I was like, yeah, Beyonce only has 24 hours in a day, but so do murderers. And they get a lot more done, relatively speaking. Grandma, and I shut my laptop, walked away as though I'd accomplished something. You know when you get that feeling on the internet when you like think you've accomplished something, but you haven't at all? But I forgot that it was Facebook. So immediately, all of my aunts and uncles started calling me, like, Ellie, you doing okay out there in Los Angeles? So you're talking about murder on Facebook again, you okay? Just want you to know we love you, we support you. Read your Bible, click. Hey, God, I have that crap on Tumblr. Anybody in here have a Tumblr? Oh, yeah, shout out to that social media site. So Tumblr is awesome because people can ask you questions, but they can do so anonymously because, as everybody knows, anonymity plus the internet usually brings out the best in people. So, like, I got on there recently, and there was this question from an anonymous person, and all it said was, are you a feminist? And I was like, I don't know. Frankly, I didn't know that that was an option for me until very recently. I thought all of this kind of prevented me from all of that, but apparently, they're just letting anybody into the club now, which I think is very exciting. The problem is, like, I just started caring about the environment, and now it's like, women too, really? I'm one white privileged male, like, what do you want from me? I make internet videos for a living, and before you all are like, is it porn? Relax, yes it is. A lot of gay Grinch porn out there. A lot of gay Grinch porn. Who's watching gay Grinch porn, you ask? Exactly. Who's? Got it. I'm the number one result. If you Google, what would it look like if Leonardo DiCaprio had sex with Mr. Bean? And they had a baby. Magically, it's a long search, who grew up to look maybe gay. That's how I like to describe myself, maybe gay. A lot of my friends say, Elliot, you're a metrosexual. I say, no. I prefer maybe gay. Keep them guessing. Who doesn't like a little mystery? I'm not maybe gay. I'm actually married to a definitely woman. I know, because I've checked twice. It's going great. No, my wife and I have been married for 7 years, which, thank you. I feel like it's pretty impressive, especially for a 15-year-old. It's true. I was 8 years old, and my mom was like, Elliot, what do you want for your birthday? And I said, I told you, Mom, monogamy. And she's like, Elliot, I don't even think you know what monogamy is. And I said, yes, I do. It's a board game. And then it didn't work out. I was a sassy little black kid. Marriage changes you guys, it really does. It changes you a lot, you don't expect it. One day you wake up and you're just this. It's terrible. Supposedly, now though, we're supposed to be entering into what's called the 7-year itch, which for those of you who don't know what the 7-year itch is, statistically speaking, committed couples will enter into a rough patch where they start questioning things and having doubts in regard to the person with whom they've chosen to spend the entirety of their lives. And the word they use to describe this periodic existential crisis is itch. Is that an itch or, oh no, it's just a life gone awry? Is this a bug bite or, oh no, it's just all-encompassing regret? I didn't. Do you have any Neosporin or like a lawyer at all? I'm just kidding. I don't believe in the 7-year itch. I don't even think of it as a 7-year itch. For me, it's like a 7-year, if I use a pillow, she'll go peacefully. Okay, so for starters, that's a murder joke. Here's the thing. I would never actually murder my wife. For one, I Googled it, super against the rules. Like, they're adamant. Don't murder your wife. That's like rule number one. And also though, we have like a puppy who, he's a Maltipoo and he sleeps in the bed with us. And I know that like the night that I'm finally like, okay, I'm gonna murder, and I like got the pillow or whatever, I'm gonna look over and my dog's gonna be like, what are you doing? And then my wife is gonna open her eyes and she's gonna be like, what are you doing? And then I'm gonna be like, sleepwalking, go back to bed. And then she's gonna be like, you were murdering me, weren't you? And I'm going to have to be like, no, I shouldn't wake the sleepwalking, it's very dangerous, blah, blah, blah. And then, for the rest of my life, anytime I don't want to walk my dog, my wife is going to be like, well, remember that time I caught you murdering me? And I don't have to deal with that. So, just relax. I'm not going to kill my wife. Can't disappoint my dog. Or the cops. You guys have dogs? Any dogs in here? Not in here, but like any dog people. Yo, if there's a dog in here, that'd be dope. Send them up right after me. Between me and Mike, it's just gonna be a golden retriever. I met a girl one time who hates dogs. Like, hated. And for no reason. It wasn't like she was attacked as a kid or was Indian. She just actually hated dogs. And she would brag about it. She'd be like, I hate dogs so much. If a guy has a dog, it's game over. I won't date a guy with a dog. I hate dogs. I hate them. And I'm like, you know who hates you? Shot in the dark? God, maybe? Like, people do too, but it starts with God. Like, God hates her, all the people hate her. And then ironically, the hate train ends at dogs. Like, she's never had a dog walk up to her and be like, yo, heard about your preference, because that would be a miracle. God's not gonna let that happen to her. I specifically requested the giant cross. Thank you guys for accommodating. It's perfect. I grew up in a very religious environment, and I had a great time. I have no jokes, just playing in. There's actually going to be an altar call at the end of this set. If any of you are worried like you might be going to hell, just let me know. You came here prepared to laugh and enjoy music, but you will leave prepared to die. You're welcome. My mom called me recently. She's a therapist, and she called me. Shocker. And she sounded very upset. Apparently, she'd seen some photos of me on the internet. Consuming alcohol. I don't know how many photos you saw, maybe one or two. 100, and I pick up the phone, and she's like, Elliot, I'm worried about the amount that you've been drinking because I fear you may have what's called an addictive personality. And I said, Mom, I don't even know what an addictive personality is. but I'm pretty sure I want one. Real bad. It's true though, I think I have what is called an addictive personality. Like, it's a good thing I'm married because I think I would kind of go off the deep end if I didn't have, like, that's an important thing in life, just so you know, like, have something that anchors you a little bit. Because, like, I've never done cocaine, and I never would do cocaine. Unless someone came up to me and they're like, Ellie, do you want to do cocaine? Because that's called being stuck between a crack rock and a hard place. And, like, I don't believe in peer pressure, but I do believe in doing everything to fit in, so it's like, what can you do? I still have fun, though. I hang out with single people a lot, which is great. I was hanging out with a group of single people a couple months ago, and everybody had been drinking a little bit, and this girl had been drinking a lot. And she turns to me, and we're all, like, sitting in this, like, circle or whatever, and she's like, okay, this is where we're gonna get to know each other a little bit right now. But she was only staring at me, and she's like, we're gonna do a question game. Your turn, Elliot. You go one. Okay. What is the happiest moment of your whole life? But before I could say Space Camp, she goes, oh, I bet I know it's when you got married. Which, first of all, no. Like, no guy, like, when he gets married, that's his happiest moment ever. That's just not. If a guy says that, like, getting married is the happiest moment of his life, he's either lying or he's gay, because gay weddings are awesome. I went to a gay wedding one time, okay, and their color scheme, listen to this, was vibrant taupe. Like, it's not enough that they have the rainbow, now they're just manufacturing new colors all the time. But back to Space Camp. So they don't tell you that it's going to be the happiest moment of your life when you arrive at Space Camp. They don't even, like, put it in the flyer. Okay, so you get there, and they're like, what we're going to do is we're going to take you, and we're going to put you in the back seat of a tiny airplane. Okay, which are words that should never go together, all right? And they put you in a plane with three other nerdstronauts, right? And they strap me in or whatever, and the plane takes off, and it goes into the sky, okay? I have no idea what's about to happen. And there's a pilot, and it's like in Florida, and there's like this coast, and it's like the beaches, and it's beautiful, and I'm in the clouds, all right? And so then, I'm in the little thing, and I got my little thing on, or whatever, you know, you've seen pictures, and the pilot goes, okay, disengage. And then the pilot, this is not a joke, he turns the key off and the plane just goes boom. Which, in hindsight, I'm not entirely sure he was supposed to do that. I think that was against the rules. But at the time, I was like, this is great! And so, what happened, at that moment, the plane just starts to just go boom. And for a brief but memorable time, I was weightless, okay? And at the time, I had this little bag of, like, Skittles in my lap, okay? The Skittles, right, I grabbed them, they floated in front of my face, and I ate a Skittle out of it. And then the pilot turns the keys back on, and he safely lands the plane, and I spent the next 20 years wondering what the crap any of this is for, okay? Till I come to Tennessee, and they're like, have you had our lemonade? And I'm like, everything makes sense. Like, it was beautiful. It's good times. But yeah, no, getting married was like, close second, for sure. And anybody asks, like, it was really good. What else? I have a cool wife. A lot of guys don't have cool wives. For example, a cool wife, by the way, like, a lot of dudes, when they get married or they have a girlfriend or whatever, they end up with regular wives or girlfriends. And what happens is if you screw up with, like, a regular wife, they'll be like, I can't believe you did that. And then they'll, like, go tell Monica. I just assume they all have Monicas. And right now, if you're in the audience and you're like, my name's Monica, then you're the Monica. That's it. That's a dumb joke. That one's just for me. But the difference, though, is with a cool wife, if I screw up, I just get murdered. Like, there's no, like, I can't believe it. She just takes out the knife and she's like, you're dead. And so, the last time I got murdered was a couple years ago. My buddy comes up to me, and I'll leave you guys on this fun tale. He comes up to me and he's like, hey, it's my birthday and I want to go to Vegas. Let's get a bunch of dudes together and let's go to Vegas and go ask your wife. And I said, okay, will do. So I go to my wife and I'm like, hey, babe, is it cool if I go partake in a level of debauchery with a group of single dudes in a city also known as Sin City? And then she said, hey, Leonardo DiCaprio. She's going with Leonardo DiCaprio. I don't know why she's funny. Anyway, she's like, go, have fun, have a great time. Enjoy yourself. She goes, dance, gamble. If you run out of money, get some out of the savings account. That money's just sitting there anyway. And then she says just one thing. When you're in Vegas with a group of single dudes, do not go to a... You nailed it. You did it. It was perfect. So, I go to my friend, like, yeah, let's do it. So we all get in the car, and we go to Vegas, and then the first night I'm having a ball, okay? And I'm like, I don't know if I've ever been to Vegas. I'm like sitting down at the tables, and like I keep getting money. They don't tell you that. You can get money, and I just keep getting and getting it. And I'm drinking a copious amount of what's called whiskey, which, by the way, they say tequila makes your clothes fall off, but whiskey tastes awesome. So I'm having a wonderful evening. We go to bed, right? Here's another thing about Vegas. When you first arrive in Las Vegas, you're like, there's so much to do. And then when the second night in Vegas rolls around, you're like, I'm dead on the inside. So the second night rolls around, and we're all, this group of like six dudes, we're walking down what's called Las Vegas Boulevard, which is also known as the Strip. It's a strip of like casinos and hotels and all that stuff. And this guy like pops out, and he goes, yo, fellas, how y'all feel about a strip club tonight? But I knew I couldn't go, okay? But I wasn't gonna be like, I can't go. So I made up a lie. And I was like, oh no, man, that's ridiculous. Me and my friends, we've been to strip clubs before. They're boring. I didn't know if they were boring or not. I had no idea. I was lying. I was like, what is the craziest thing that you can hook me and my friends up with? And he gets like super quiet. And he like looks around and he gets all shifty-eyed. And then after a moment, and in my head, by the way, I'm thinking like, I stumped him. Like nobody's ever asked for anything worse than a strip club in Vegas. And this is literally, this actually happened. These are the words that came out of his mouth. He goes, there's a place about 2 miles from here that I can take you to where you and your friends can have sex with a goat. And my first thought was like, well, that's not on the list of things I can't do. Now, I can stand before you today and say that I never have had sex with a goat or any farm animal, but not a day goes by that I don't regret not going to see that goat, okay? For a couple reasons. I just have a lot of questions. That's it, okay? The only part about having sex with a goat that I'm not curious about is the sex with a goat part. I want to know everything else. Do they take credit cards? What's their Yelp review system like? My actual goat sex fantasy, and I think we all have one if we're honest with ourselves, I think he takes you and it's just a house from like a 90s sitcom, you know? Like, let's say the house from Step by Step, remember that show? Yeah, and the door opens and it's Alan Thicke, which you might be thinking Alan Thicke was with Growing Pains, but I'm mixing it up. It's my goat sex fantasy. You don't have to do it for yours. I'm not gonna push my goat sex fantasy on your goat sex fantasy. But Alan Thicke opens the door and he's like, what can I help you with? And you're like, goat. And in your head, you're like, oh, I shouldn't have brought the corsage. This was overkill. And then he like brings you into the house and takes you into a separate room, which is like covered in like plush carpet and ottoman and like velvet curtains or whatever. And then like John Mayer's Your Body is a Wonderland playing in the background. You're like, this is kind of nice, actually. It's a little dated, but it's a nice song. And there's a champagne flute filled with champagne for you. And next to that, there's a Tupperware dish also filled with champagne for the goat. And then the door opens and the goat walks in and the fantasy ends there because I'm not a monster. So, mostly though, I just want to go like have eye contact with the goat just for a second, just to like see how it's doing. Cause that goat's still out there, you guys. Like, is it all like glassy-eyed and like dead on the inside? Perhaps a victim of goat sex trafficking, which is a problem nobody in this country wants to talk about. Or maybe I would look at the goat and be like vibrant and sassy, and I would be like, hey, are you okay? And it would say, oh, it's not so bad. It's a long joke just to build up to a bad joke. But I enjoy it. But none of that happened. Instead, a drunk friend in the back goes, let's go to the strip club! And I was like, okay. And then we went, and it was horrible, and I used a credit card, and I went home, and my wife, my cool wife, was like, did you have fun in Vegas? I was like, yeah, I did. She's like, did you do anything interesting? I'm like, nope. Did anything interesting happen at all? No, not at all. And then my wife, because here's the thing, like a regular wife, like I would have walked in and she'd be like, you're a pig! And I would have been like, you're right! But a cool wife will just like hand you a shovel and be like, dig, enjoy, good luck. So she goes, is there anything you want to tell me before I tell you something? And I said, no. Wrong answer. And she flipped the laptop around and she goes, what's Sapphire? And I was like, I know, $15 for a Jack and Coke is ridiculous. Recently, my friend came back to me and he was like, it's my birthday again. I want to go back to Vegas. Let's get the gang back together. Let's go do it. Go ask your wife. So I go to my wife and I'm like, hey, babe, can I go partake in a level of debauchery with a group of single dudes again? And I promise not to do that thing I said I wouldn't do the first time. And then she said, hey, Mr. Bean. She calls me Mr. Bean. So that's how I got kicked out of the Garden of Eden, you guys. That's the end of that. Hey, I want to thank Olin for having me. And I also, guys, give Olin a round of applause, and also give Mike Falzone a round of applause. Yeah, guys, thank you. Thank you, guys. That was really fun. Well, good morning, everybody. What a great fucking guy. All right, guys. We got another funny guy coming up. His name is Mike Falzone. Mike Falzone! Look at this! Got a little drinking going on. Right, there you go. There you go. Hey, why don't you bring two bottles of water out here? There's like 50 bottles of water out here. He needs more water.
I have to finish one whole one before I start. I'm gonna take one sip out of all the other ones. If you see me with a face on, like it looks like I'm concentrating, I'm not. I'm just trying not to swear as much as I want to swear. You got a while to go, you go. This is just kind of me wasting your time right now. Guys, first of all, I know this might feel a little weird, but sit down. Hey, you filming this whole thing? Do me a favor, man. Don't laugh. Don't laugh. I don't want to see that camera shake. If I get this video back and it's all looks like a cell phone video, I can't use that. Don't laugh at any of these jokes, please. That goes double for you guys. You guys doing okay? You good? You real bored yet, you think? Give me a minute. We'll fix that. Elliot was talking about everyone being nice, and you know that. You live here, most of you. Everyone is super nice. Today, I had an experience at breakfast, and I sat next to an old man, and the old man said, hey, what do you do? What are you doing here? Said me and my buddy, and I pointed to Elliot because I used that term loosely. I said, me and my buddy are in town for a comedy show. We're doing comedy. And he lost it. And he was so excited to talk to somebody who wasn't a musician in Nashville. And he was so, so excited. And immediately, this guy's like 80. And that's like, if I'm lowballing it, he was 80 years old. And he was so excited to tell me every joke he's heard that he can remember in his 80 years of being a person. But he did it in such a way where he was so excited by the end of every joke, he ramped up his pitch because he was having a ball of a time. So every joke sounded like this. A lot of Groucho Marx stuff, first of all. He was very old. He was in black and white, this guy. It was like Pleasant almost. Remember that? Nope, everybody here was born in 1997. Here we go. So his jokes were like, and then Buddy Hackett had this one joke, and he comes out with a cigar.
Fifty.
We don't remember the same things. Telephones, you remember? Nope. You guys, a lot of people say I look like Jesus. I think those people are lazy at making references. I don't think I look like Jesus at all. I think I look like what white people hope Jesus looks like. I look, you know what I look like? I look like the cartoon in all the CCD books. You know? That's Jesus. Oh, Jesus, yeah, I know, that's the guy who eats alone at the mall 5 times a week. I know Jesus. I know that guy. Didn't he always hang out with several other dudes? Okay. As he said, my name is Mike Falzone, for anyone who doesn't know who I am, which is most people in the world, statistically. And that was new. That was what I just thought of. Thank you. My last name is Falzone, which rhymes with?
Calzone.
Certainly does. Calzone. Nope. You had it right the first time. When everyone answered the same word, that was the right one. That was the right answer. It's calzone. It's an Italian food. And I know that because I myself am Italian, and also people tell me that all the time. Every time my name is said out loud, someone will remind me that it kind of sounds like a food. And that's just the most helpful thing you can give to another person. 3 days ago, and I give you the number of days because it's not a bit, it's a thing that, it's an event that happened. I was speaking to a lady, and she goes, Falzone, things must get crazy when you try to order Italian food, she said. She made this face like she meant it the whole time, like she meant it was a real thought from a real person that she was proud to say. Things must get what do I do? Crazy! When you try to order Italian food, a name like that. Get the kids in the basement! I don't know what you're doing. I looked at her and I said, nah, I just don't tell the waiter or waitress my last name ever. It's not part of the casual dining experience. Anybody get anything from the bar in the back before they went up here? Anybody get a drink or anything? Show of hands. Good. Woo is a very good drink. You're wooing. You tell the waiter or waitress your last name? Nope. You tell them your first name? Absolutely not. I've never seen somebody walk into a Denny's and be like, hello, my name is Gary Stevens. I'll take anything on a skillet, the Cheesecake Bites, Gary Stevens. So my family, Mrs. Stevens, little Joey Stevens, Tiffany Stevens, Jr. My name is Walter Cromlett. I'll take a bacon and cheese omelet. Thank you. Happy to be here at Denny's. Who clapped? Don't clap. Enough. So don't clap. It's not part of anyone's process. The name thing, not the clapping. Yeah, hello, this is Mike. I'll take 2 cheese calzones for delivery. No problem, Mike. Can we get a last name on that order? Next joke. Trying to lose weight, you guys? Trying to lose weight? Anybody else trying to lose weight? You can put up your hand, but I'm not going to see him because of the silhouette thing I said before. I've been trying to lose weight. Today, for example, I just had a sandwich. 6-inch rather than the foot long. Pretty good. It was an ice cream sandwich. But figured since it wasn't a foot long, it has to be less calories, right? I know it depends on the bread. I was thinking about this a little inside info. I was thinking about changing that joke. I hate to break the illusion for you. But I was thinking about changing that joke to, all I had today were 3 apples. Did I say apples? I meant pizza. 3 ice cream pizzas. I think the other one's funnier, but in my heart, I read the second one. You already laughed at the first one, so what the hell? I'll give the second one, what the heck? Sorry. Shh. My friends keep trying to, did you laugh? Give me the camera, I'll take it from here. Why do I do the walk and talk videos anymore? I laugh at my own jokes. My friends keep trying to get me to go indoor rock climbing. You guys ever gone indoor rock climbing? Wow. I don't even care if you're lying, because it's a comedy show. I'm not gonna like grill you afterwards, like, did ya? Don't care. My friend's trying to get me to go indoor rock climbing, and I say no, because I don't wanna go at all. Not even a little bit. And it's not that the idea of bringing the rocks from the outside to the inside isn't an exhilarating idea to think about, because it is. But my point is, I can't lift my own weight up that shit when it's outside. What's adding walls and a ceiling gonna do? How's that gonna help my situation? Make any cry of pain I have echo and eventually get to somebody who can help them? Maybe? That's best case scenario. And I'm like, man, I'll go on one condition. Do they have those harnesses that I could hook into and rainbow six my way down if I happen to accidentally make it to the top? And with a smile, my friend George goes, nah, man, no harnesses, but the floor is padded. I said, great, one definitely takes the place of the other one. Absolutely. When I'm 50 feet up in the air, I'm gonna be like, oh, thank God. That looks soft down there. We should be all right. Padding on the floor makes me feel safe if I fell from a standing position. If I was tying my shoes, getting ready to go up the rock, and I fell over for a second, I'd be like, well, thank God. Goodness, thank goodness. Bottles of water. My point is, I don't want to have to train for my hobby in order to have a hobby, right? And some people sitting there, some fitness nuts, being like, training isn't a hobby, it's a lifestyle. I just ate an ice cream sandwich today, so go talk to somebody else. Anybody else? I don't need to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning, make sure I can do 500 push-ups to keep watching Netflix. That doesn't happen. I'll take Netflix every day, all the time. I want to open up my heart to you guys. There's a couple of people really looking forward to what I'm about to say next. None of them are sitting out here, but you just wait, be invested. I love professional wrestling so much. You hear how no one wooed? You know why? Only one. I have 40 minutes on professional wrestling. You guys comfortable? I love it, man, but I don't say it out loud because people are dicks about it. Penises. People are penises about it. Hey, shut up. You guys are being penises. Sorry, I keep snorting into the mic. Like I'm a sea lion. That doesn't have anything to do with the joke. I love it so much, but I can't talk about it because people are that way. That's just the way people are. And the number one thing people say to me all the time, I'm like, I like professional wrestling. People will jump at the opportunity to say, you know it's fake, right? You know it's fake? Because it's predetermined, and it's like a dance between two human beings. It's a theatrical performance that is way over all your guys' heads. That's highbrow entertainment, professional wrestling. People would be like, it's fake. People love to tell you that shit is fake. You ever go to the movies with that person? They tap you on the shoulder, you go see Fast and Furious, and like, you know cars don't always go that fast, right? You know that. It's fake, you're 30, you get it. A car can't fly through a building, so that's fake. You know what I say to those people, other than shut up? I say, don't have kids, ever. You go pick up your kid at daycare, and he's crisscross applesauce watching Aladdin or whatever. You tap him on the face, and you're like, if you rub antiques, genies don't always pop out, start dancing around, singing songs. I'm a shitty parent. Shifty parent. Oh, you like the Karate Kid? You know it takes more than washing cars to win a karate tournament, right? You know that? If you guys were way older than you are, this place would be on fire. Your parents love that joke, probably, almost. Was that a dad in the back trying to force out a laugh? Ha ha ha, I got it! Keep talking about wrestling, I love that. It's fake. I hate to bring it to you. Next time I do that, throw a fish at my face. Because I'm annoying myself. It's fake. Pro wrestling is... Are you sure? Pro wrestling is... Give me a second. The one where they paint their faces and they put strings around their... They fight each other. That's not how people solve their problems. Throwing each other up against brightly colored elasticy ropes, that's not what arguments. Okay. That's not what arguments. That one was for me, that one. I'm an only child by a round of hands. Any only children in here? One. Everyone else, enough. It's me and this shit. Everyone else is related. Thank you for bringing your brothers and sisters out tonight. That was really cool of you. I'm an only child, and all the kids used to make fun of me when I was in grade school, man. Did you get made fun of, one girl? Yeah. Sucks. And they're all like, you're spoiled! You need all the attention! And the only way I could stop that from happening was to join in and be like, yeah, and when my parents die, I got no one else! Say that out loud. It hurts. It hurts to say it out loud. It burns when it comes up. Yeah, yeah. It hurt my ears. Sorry. That's the truth. You better have several husbands or whatever. Or kids that are cool enough, you can call them your brother and sister. But I don't know how kids work. You grow a family from sex, I think. Stop laughing. Stop. This is a true story that I've never told anyone but a bunch of other people before. There was one shut up. There was one year. Enough. There was. There was one year. There was one year for Christmas, and all I wanted was it. Do you guys know what Rock'em Sock'em Robots are? It's a yes or no question. What if you ever answered a yes or no question out loud, ever? Everybody have their homework? Okay, so there was one year, do you guys shut up, that I wanted. Rock'em Sock'em Robots came out like in the 70s, right, parents? Something like that, 60s, 70s. I can still see you guys. You guys are the light. It's all these guys that are like mystery, guess who, pieces. So, no, enough. So that's all I wanted, was this Rock'em Sock'em Robots, but it was an updated version. It was electronic, and the characters, don't drop anything, were Street Fighter characters, right? It was Guile and Ryu, right? And that's all I wanted. So I asked my parents at least 47 times, and their answer was, Are you sure you want that? Are you sure that's what you want? Gotta be absolutely sure, this is very expensive. You're probably only gonna get one thing, so you gotta be sure that one's it. Are you sure? My answer was always yes. And then Christmas morning came around. And since I'm an only child, I got that shit. Right? And then this one girl, I only got it! So I woke up Christmas morning, and I unboxed it, and it was beautiful, and I set it up, and I put batteries in it, and it was glorious. And then I just kind of looked at it for a bunch of weeks, because it's a two-player game. So I'm not going to take you through the rest of the story, but yada, 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 a bunch of years later, I'm super good at texting. Yeah, it was easy to win. Yeah, I needed that because I was an only child. But so was hide and go seek. Some of you know where I'm going with this. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ready or not? Who wants $1 million? So, I guess if there's any one big takeaway, it's that I kind of hate looking like this. It's not because of the Jesus thing, and it's not because I'm so squishy in the midsection, but it is because stoners think that they can come up to me and just talk to me about food combinations. They think they just made up all the time. For any kids in the audience, a stoner is somebody who spins around rocks real fast. I had a roommate like that very recently, and he was like, yeah, go make me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, but instead of bread, use Pop-Tarts. Make the Pop-Tarts be the bread. How do you make that? Do you ask him? It's not how you make Pop-Tarts be bread. It's like, yeah, what if we went to the store and we got some cheese and we melted it? Then we have melted cheese. We go back to the store. Maybe it's a different store. We get some tomatoes, squish them up. Then we have like a tomato paste. Serve it hot on bread, almost like a pizza, but not. Almost like a pizza, but not. Yep, that's just a pizza. That's just a pizza. And you didn't invent it. You can order one, but that's where the train stops for you. I love pizza so much, I would never want to order it to do anything. We're changing the locks. Get out. Get out of the house. All right, man. How about We'd lose the tomatoes, and it would just wrap the cheese in the bread, and that's it. Oh, like a calzone? What was your name again? Guys, thank you so much. My name is Mike Calzone. Guys, it's so much fun. Thank you so much for coming to bring this up.
What a great guy, huh?
Give it up for Mike Calzone one more time.
Thanks, buddy. We got some music coming up from Tessa Violet.
You guys ready for this?
Oh, get ready for this.
this way? Is that the direction? This way? All right, there we go. Sorry, guys. Woohoo, it's a party. Hey, so my name is Tessa Violet. Woohoo, yeah. And some of you may know me as Mika Kitty. For those of you who don't, I make videos on the internet. I was surprised when I started making videos how mean people can be. And it just had me thinking, why are people so cruel? I've never once in my entire life said something mean about anyone ever.
Baby,
trapped, mostly troubled. Speaking of being troubled and making bad life decisions, has anyone here ever dated a narcissist? Yeah, cool, me too. At one point I realized, I don't like the way I'm being treated. And then I realized, oh, I don't have to date this person anymore. This song's called Sorry, I'm Not Sorry.
Yeah! This is the first song. It's called Tuning My Guitar.
Thank you. Thank you. It's hot.
Out there, can you sing me a beat? Never mind.
I know it. This is the real rock and roll sound. It's the 20th century, folks.
You guys, this one's called Out With A Bang. I don't condone living like this, but it's a fun song to sing, so let's sing it. Seriously. That's it, guys!
life.
Meerkat has to see some behind the scenes stuff that no one's
seen. Oh, yeah.
Did you hear Kat? You go to your Play Store, what do you use? iPhone or iPad? Okay, there's your App Store. I don't know what that was. go to your App Store and Meerkat, MWERKAT. And then at Spirits of Y Galloway. You're gonna see some awesome stuff. I'll be rolling a whole bunch.
Old Chefski.
Oh, familiar. I think I've seen that one before.
Familiar?
Yeah.
Are you from here?
No.
So, okay.
No.
And how have you seen us?
I'm saying her name.
Oh.
Internet world.
Oh, yeah.
You know Owen, right? You comment like on Owen stuff, right?
No, Mike.
Mike.
I asked Mike to go get coffee with
him
and he didn't respond. I was the only child.
He's busy. He's super busy. Super busy. Okay, so what was your favorite part of the show?
When Mike called her
that was me.
That was you? I was the only
child. So you
I was the one sitting in the front, like, crying at, like, the joke. I think he could hear my tears when he said that he had nobody to play the game with, because about a minute before he made the joke, I was like, he's going to talk about how he got a two-person game because he's an only child, but he couldn't play it with another person because he's an only child.
So you saw
I knew that was going to happen because all the only child.
Oh,
it's a problem
really?
That we have.
Okay, so thank you for doing the show. Make sure you're doing the Meerkat, because there's, I think he's coming next week, too, right?
Oh, yeah. I think so. I'm not sure.
Either way, there's going to be some behind the scenes stuff. I'll be chilling with you because I live in West Hollywood. So we're going to be chilling with you.
Right, there you go.
So the Meerkat.
So the App Store.
What do you got? iPhone or
Android? iPhone.
Okay. Well, let's go here. What do you call it?
Internet browser.
Apple Store. Blah, blah, blah.
Apple Store.
I love Apple. I just started to really use it. But yeah, donut, M-W-R-K-A-T.
Bye, Internet.
Bye. These are not internet. This is people.
Bye, Internet.
People on the internet.
No,
if there are people watching this,
they're using data or wireless to stream it.
But
that is
not
the internet.
They're using the internet to watch.
I love
but
the internet.
These are people.
I'm the internet. If you've seen Andrew Voltron, we're all the internet.
There we go. All right, sweet.
Bye.
Internet, you gotta be kidding me. I'll call people out on that every time. You are not the one. The internet was created. How was the show?
What do you do?
So
excellent.
Good?
Excellent. Rusty killing it with the rock and roll.
Yeah.
And all the comedy. Solid. And they're going to be coming back week three.
Yeah.
There's
going to
be a bunch of comedy.
Well, heck yeah, man. Well, thanks for coming in and supporting.
Yeah, man. Thanks for hanging out.
So, man, how was the show?
Killer.
Killer?
Best show in Nashville.
Really?
Yes. Wow. I haven't been here long, but...
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Awesome. Better than I was expecting. Way better than I was expecting.
Fantastic. That's awesome. That's awesome. Well, thanks for coming out and supporting.
Yeah.
Are you two coming over?
Huh?
You two coming over?
Oh, yeah.
What about Mike? Can you go with Mike?
Actually, we're going with Mike. But I wasn't expecting to see Mike.
Wow. Okay.
I was kind of surprised. I saw it last minute. I didn't know it was going to be here until, like... 10 minutes before I came, so walked over.
That's a plus, huh?
Yeah. It was definitely worth the half an hour walk.
Right. Well, great. Well, thanks for coming out and supporting me.
Yeah.
And everybody.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for you, what would we do? Right?
No, if it wasn't for you,
what would we do? What would we do?
No, it's not because of you guys. You guys did a great job putting everything on.
Well, we fight to survive, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We gotta make it happen. For you guys. But, yeah, so check it out. There's a Meerkat app. You know live streaming?
Huh?
You know this live streaming app?
Yeah, we do it for this thing called Spike Ball.
Spike Ball?
Yeah, you know Spike Ball?
No.
Spike Ball, you guys should go check it out. It's,
yeah.
It's like Foursquare and volleyball and steroids. It's killer. Go check it out.
Well, definitely. Well, this is Meerkat. Go to your app store and download it. Meerkat. Go with a K. With a K. But yeah, because we'll be doing all kinds of behind the scenes and always for the rest of the month. And when I'm doing all this stuff, it's legit. Rock on, man. Thanks again for your support, dude. We're out.
Hello again.
Hello. Oh. And it's you. You. How dare y'all show your faces around here after killing us in Halo. I know you are. There will be a rematch of redemption. We shall get a redemption!
Hey guys.
So,
how are you doing?
It's me. See, now that's what I'm talking about. Beautiful people, not internet people.
You guys are all beautiful people. Yeah. I don't like it when people say internet people. Yeah. Hey, what's going on, internet?
No, when they use the internet.
The internet is a personal experience, man.
Yeah.
I was connecting on a personal level right now. You and I are having an individual conversation. Whenever you're watching this, you're not thinking about the other 500 people that are watching it. You're thinking about you watching it and me talking to you.
Boom.
That's how you need to think about it.
Hey, man. See, you look into the lens, man. That's awesome. Good stuff. That was from Grant Ivy right there. Go to his Instagram. All right, let's see. Hey, how you doing? This is a camera. Live streaming. We're live streaming. Meerkat. Isn't that amazing?
That's not my mom.
No, I was waiting for her shout out. Well, no, that didn't work.
To my dad.
To your cousin.
Oh, are we still doing this?
Well, hey.
Your setup is very nice here.
Well, this is actually Grant built this. Grant, I don't know if you met Grant.
Yeah, Grant.
Okay, well, that's awesome. That's symptom.
I got it done today.
Today? Wow. Rock on.
After that, we went to your
Really? How was that? Can you smell it? Can you smell it? They didn't check
anything. We're like vegetarian and they put chicken on her.
Oh. So don't go to Moe's.
Don't go to Moe's.
Dang, they can't get it. See? Don't do anything wrong with these girls. These girls will come at you. You nervous? Ah, you'll be nervous. Well, this is Meerkat. This is live stream. It's a live stream application. It's MWERKAT. And some I don't know who designed it, but some awesome person. But basically, it links up to your Twitter, and you can follow like Olin. You can follow Olin or Tessa. I don't know if she's doing it yet. But,
we love Tessa.
We love Tessa.
How about me, Katie?
Well, who were you here for? Tessa?
Rusty
Grant
and Tessa Violet. Mike Fonseca.
Okay, fantastic.
Only Rogers, because he, I guess, created this
thing. Yeah, that's right. Well, fantastic. Well, thank you for your support. If it wasn't for you two, there you go. If it wasn't for you, it's people. Yeah, there we go. If it wasn't for you two and all these wonderful people, we wouldn't know what to do. Because we're crazy, right? We're all crazy artists. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Do a
handshake. Okay. Fantastic. All right. Thanks, ladies. What's up, man? How you doing? You made it, huh? You made it.
Yeah. Two more times. Get running on the
ground. Where are you from
here? I came from North Georgia. I'm live now, apparently.
North Georgia.
Several.
What was your favorite part of the show?
I was really into comedy.
Comedy?
Yes. And, the literature on top of great music.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. If it wasn't for you and all these other wonderful people, we wouldn't be doing this. So,
yeah.
Rock.
And you keep
appreciate
your hype man stuff going, man. You're running the show. You're keeping everybody alive. Yeah.
Nah, well, thank you. I love it. I feed off that energy and give it back. So, boom, that's all we can do. But thank you. All right. Talk to you soon. Later. That is such a cool t-shirt, Brad. That turned into something quite nice.
Yeah. Thank you, caterers.
Thank you, caterers, for leaving that behind. Can you get rid of sodas?
We're getting rid of you. We actually sold some agave, which we never sell.
It's good stuff.
What
about shirts? T-shirts.
Posters.
We're like shoe washing, right?
No. Well, they, some of them saw it being made.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Where'd you see what Haley made? Haley made a cool, design, art design. Like that, or put it where they can see the that back part too. I think so. Let me see. Bailey, are you watching? Yes. I think. She may be there. She may have stepped away, but she's definitely... Don't say anything about Halo.
I'm not going to say anything.
It was a pleasure to meet you.
It was a pleasure to meet you. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, likewise. I'm glad y'all had fun. Thanks for supporting all of
us. Yeah.
And I'll be sure to kind of set this up. I want to set this up.
All right. Olin said he's down. Just talk to Olin.
You good? Okay. Well, we're going to do it.
Yeah.
We're going to do it.
All right. Just let us know when.
All right. I'll figure it out.
All right.
All right. Just don't hurt us too bad.
Is this live in your cat?
No. She said yes.
Are you
the
best friends?
Alright.
Bailey? Bailey, right?
Oh, so this lights you up too? You're lit?
Thank you. Is she on there? Can you hear me right now?
Yeah.
Are we gonna be best friends?
See what she says. There's a delay.
A lot of women in the room. I'm surrounded by men.
Tell her what just happened. Tell her what just happened.
What just happened?
Sister.
Oh, yeah, my little sister's got married.
Have a glass. Would you like to have some?
See, I need to put that on the front.
Yeah. like a platform for the bottom.
No, no, not the actual.
No, 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 like put the little screen.
It was very good, like an interactive screen. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Like they could touch.
Like an iPad, like a screen that you could touch.
So this should be really good. Yeah, like this, like
the tightening. That's right. So I'm not alone. Yeah. Maybe I'll meerkat and drink tonight.
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking.
You want to have one?
Yeah. No, somebody left wine at the soda parlor.
Oh really?
Yeah. You want to have some wine?
We definitely partake in things.
Yeah.
We don't drink.
This is an unopened bottle of fresh wine.
Wine just like it's classy.
12% red. I'm gonna get drunk tonight. I have a very low tolerance for alcohol. So, like genuinely, I really do. I can have a glass, and that's it. And that's a small glass.
So. I'd love to see this.
Yeah.
I would love to see Jake tipsy.
I get really bubbly, and the pitch of my voice goes up slightly. It's like, yeah, this is awesome. I like get really excited about stuff.
There's like this point where I'm like really fun, and then you just turn into the worst human being.
Uh-oh. I've never
the
been
worst
drunk.
Version of myself comes out, so there's like I've only there's been a fine line.
You may drink too fast.
Yeah.
That happens if I drink too fast.
Yeah. I just get really warm and heavy. I feel really heavy. And then I'm not happy anymore. It's like, my head feels heavy. But that warm, tickly, bubbly feeling.
Yeah, when your legs start to
yeah.
Cold.
I'm like, I want to feel this forever. Now I get alcoholism.
Okay, well, I guess it's getting close. We could probably start tearing stuff down, huh?
No, we will sell.
You see how much money's still out there,
Casey? I'm not talking about this. I'm talking about, like, this stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Want me to hold that while you do it?
Hey, is there a Sharpie?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to start it down.
Someone's you by that.
It looks like a Sharpie in your hand, though.
So yeah, I think I need to put that on here. What you think? Like front?
Yeah, put it on the box. Better than a screen.
That way people can read what's going on, so I don't have to say it. I'm trying to sound like I'm pitching.
Get on meerkat!
Meerkat.
Sign up on meerkat. We can watch stuff.
Meerkat sales rep.
You would kill yourself if you could think of a super way to live.
Stupider than that, Jesse.
I'm trying to get like a giant picture of everyone who wears this. Just like stay over here so we can.
She and I were like, thinking when suddenly she chimes in and she's like,
I do the same thing when I'm on set, when I'm in films, I'm starring in a film. I do this, this is how I move like a robot. But then but for some reason when I come in, it's like, it's like this. Hey, my name's Katch. Right? That's what I do. But when the final thing is like, my name's Katch. It's the editor that So how was the show? How do you feel?
Good. Feel well.
Feel well?
Yeah. I would say this is my best band show, and it feels good to know that, okay, it gets better and not worse, because the first one was very, very rough, and now it's just kind of rough.
Nice. Okay. Tessa, real quick, where can everybody find you
in your music? YouTube.com/Katch, which is hard to spell and understand what the word means. So instead, you can just Google Tessa Violet, like the flower, or the
plant. Yeah! And you rock, great voice. ET it up.
What? I've never seen that movie. I know!
You're cool, it's okay. Die Hard, you said Die Hard.
Yes.
Yay. Yippee-ki-yay, mother.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, thanks for doing what you do. You entertained all these people.
Thanks for watching.
What would we do without them, or what would we do without you?
I hope that you're having a fun night at home, and that you have a great week, and that if you're having a hard time, you start feeling better really soon.
Aww. so sweet. And we're...
He knows. He saw it.
All right, it's time to pack up.
Yeah, we should hang out or something.
Do you live in town?
Yeah, I live in Hillsboro. Like,
oh, okay. Hillsboro, okay, yeah.
Super
so
close.
Yeah.
You live on campus?
Yeah. Yep, and I'll live on campus for this next year, too.
Yeah, dude, we should hang out or something. Coffee.
Yeah, cool beans. Can I get your number or something?
Yeah, absolutely. Let me... Or you can add mine, send me a text message. Yeah, that's really cool.
What's your last name?
Clanton. C-L-A-N-T-O-N. This is really weird, and this sounds like really a-holy, but like, it's weird being at an event like this, like a YouTube thing, and people don't know my name, because if I'm there, usually the people have seen my name on a list, or like, it's weird because like, Tessa and I have, this is my girlfriend, and we've had like, we've been in the YouTube world for a while, so when we go to VidCon or Playlist, it's like, people recognize us, and it's right. Like, you know, we're people in YouTube, and then Owen's got his whole universe of outside of that,
yeah.
And it's, yeah, and it's awesome, and it's weird being here, I mean, it's incredible being here, and people are, like, encouraging about that music, and they don't even know who I am.
I love it.
Yeah. And I feel like when you're in the world of Owen, if people recognize you, they kind of...
No, but I'm about to go find out where we need to start. I'm throwing people out.
Maybe a couple shows in, and it was like, all right, I'm out.
Yeah?
I just don't even pay attention to the crowd.
But, it's funny. Yeah. It's like, for me, it's like, also, it takes to be able to just care about, you know, not be just sick on stage. It took me playing in front of, playing tons of shows by myself as a folk artist, where people did not want to hear me. Like, they were, like, actively not wanting to listen. And once, if you can, like, still have a good time doing that, then this is a breeze. Like, when you're somewhere where people want to hear you, it's just a breeze. But, yeah. I got my name.
Sorry.
Yeah, just don't tweet around.
Oh, I definitely will.
Okay, 4-2-3.
Hey, for about a show. How'd it go? How'd everything go for you?
It's good.
It's good?
I'm sweaty.
I'm sweaty.
Yeah.
They like that here. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Good interview.
Yeah.
It's time to go.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.